Welcome to Goobertown Hobbies. My name is Brent. Today we are gonna start something big. Now, I don't know when you're watching this, but Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Hope things are going well for you. Myself, I am recording this on the winter solstice, the literal darkest day of 2020. It's dark, it's cold, I haven't been getting out much. But, people are getting vaccinated and there's a lot of light at the end of the tunnel, so we just gotta get through the next couple of months. My plan for getting through the next few months is to really double down on that indoor lifestyle. I want to use this as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to get a lot of hobby progress done. And in particular, one project I'm working on is finally getting a full army painted. Despite this YouTube channel, I still don't have a fully painted army for either Age of Sigmar or 40K. But at the start of 2020, I did find a paint scheme that I really like for Slaves to Darkness. This continues to look good to me almost a year later. It's got longevity. I'm ready to commit and crank out a full army. I'm trying to document the entire process on this. So far, I've spent a lot of time assembling and prepping models. This force is going to have a mix of new figures and used figures. These colorful lads deserve a loving home. I'm committed to making the most out of this quarantine. I'm lucky enough to be in a position where I'm able to shelter in place for the darkest weeks of this COVID winter. I hope that we'll never see another winter like this one. Hopefully, this is a once-in-a-lifetime tragedy. But of course, it may also be a unique opportunity. An overload of physically distant indoor time. Pretty much the perfect conditions to tackle a big hobby project. Actually, I've got about a dozen projects going on, but this is the big one. My plan is to sit at my painting desk for a goodly amount of time. When I finally look up, the sun will be shining, it'll be my turn in line to get the vaccine, and I'll have an awesome army to play with my friends. Let's make that happen. I got a big start on the assembly, so let's start getting some models painted. I've got the Fomoroid Crusher and the Ogroid Myrmidon here. I picked these up the last time I went into my local hobby store. I'll batch paint a lot of the troops and cavalry, but these two lads are unique and they'll make a fun painting project of reasonable size. I'm gonna use these guys to add a few other colors into that sea of yellow-orange armor. I'm always looking to try new things and paint bravely the podcast, so for these fellows, I want to push myself with the airbrush a bit. They've each got hair, skin, and a bit of armor that are big enough for me to try something with. These are figures that I care about, and I really do want them to look good. But on the other hand, they're one-off models, and nobody else in the army is gonna be from either of these species. We've got some freedom to experiment. The strategy that I really want to play with is to use colorful skin tone that transitions towards Caucasian flesh for the highlights and on the belly. We're going blue on the Ogroid and purple on the Fomoroid. I'm using Vallejo Game Air colors for this. I've got a couple of shades of blue, a couple of shades of purple, and some flesh tone. I'm mixing up multiple intermediate colors in my airbrush to try to get smooth transitions. I'm using an airbrush with a small 0.2mm nozzle, and these models are both reasonably big, so I have some ability to put the highlights where I think they might look cool. Upper parts of the body are presumably better lit, and I think their pecs and tum-tums should also be a fleshier color. I'm not overthinking this though, these guys probably have rashy, splotchy skin, so almost anything I do here should work out alright. I ended up kinda batch painting this duo. They're sort of an odd couple, but it actually worked out pretty well. It was more efficient than painting them individually. Even though I'm picking some different colors, I think they'll still be cohesive with the final army. Speaking of that army, the Ogroid has a shield and the Fomoroid has a pauldron. I'll paint those in that yellow-orange. That means a pink undercoat, a zenithal highlight with white ink, and finally a coat of Indian yellow ink. You can see that I'm working on my shielding skills here. I've got aluminum foil and little plastic baggies close by to reduce the chances that I overspray and accidentally make the whole model pink or yellow. There's a very good chance that this yellow-orange armor is gonna clash with the colorful skin. I may end up backing down and painting those bits of armor black or silver or something. But let's not declare defeat too early. Let's see where this goes. I've got a bit more airbrushing to do, but first I want to make the hair black and give it a really tidy border where it meets the skin. Same with the loincloths, and same with the horns. I'll give my air compressor a chance to grab a drink and a snack while I get a few of these color blocks sorted out by hand. I want to do some cool fades with the hair, so I gave it a dry brush with white. I'll hit that with some colored ink later, and hopefully that'll look sweet. That blue skin with the orange shield might end up working out alright. We shall see. Alright, compressor, break's over. I broke out some of my favorite Liquitex inks to add some colors into the hair, the horns, and the loincloths. I've got to be more and more careful as I'm airbrushing not to make a mess of the blue and purple skin, but this is all good stuff to practice. It's always good to push ourselves and take risks and paint bravely the podcast. I finished up the airbrush steps with two thin coats of satin varnish, and I let that dry overnight. I want to make sure that the delicate coats of ink have some protection before I start throwing on the washes. Next up was using some Army Painter tones to do a blue wash on the Ogroid and a purple wash on the Fomoroid. For the next steps, I'm just batch painting these two roids, hitting them with the same shades of brown, gray, and bone to cut in some of those details. I gotta say, I'm really having fun with these Bash Brothers. These are some great models, and it's motivating to be working on some big projects this winter and knocking them out one step at a time. I really am planning on doubling down on constructive introversion this winter, an antisocial hibernation of extreme hobby productivity. I'll watch my hands assemble and paint models for the next few months, and when I look up, the sun will be shining, and it'll be time to get out there and safely reunite with the folks I love. I have no idea if this plan is a good one or not. I'll let you know. Higher hobby productivity should mean more Goobertown videos. I'm not going anywhere. I'll be right here. These are truly strange times. In the US, COVID infections are higher than they've ever been. And at the same time, the great vaccination has begun. Better times are coming. I don't know if that's 3 months away or 6 months away, but they are coming. We've all just gotta do our best to keep ourselves and the people we love safe for a little while longer. My heart goes out to everyone who's had to face this disease close up. I'm wishing you all health and happiness in the coming year. Stay strong for a few months longer, my friends. Let's try to all cross the finish line together. In this darkest of winters, we've gotta be mindful of our mental health. I've convinced myself that a hobby hibernation winter of extreme productivity will be epic fun. But I could be wrong, and this strategy is quite possibly a bad idea. Take care of yourself and take care of each other. Call your friends, call your family, hang out in Ventrilo and play some Dota. Do whatever you gotta do to seek balance and get through this. Remember, I'm always rooting for ya. Sunnier times are coming. And yeah, Happy New Year. We're putting 2020 behind us, and I really do have a good feeling about 2021. I'm convinced that this winter is gonna fly by. I've gotta seize the moment and get these models painted. I think the orange shield and the blue Ogroid are looking pretty sweet. As for the one-eyed purple people eater here, well, I don't know if you can see it on the screen, but the purple and orange are clashing quite badly. I can always pull the ripcord and paint the armor a different color, but let's see if there's a way to make this work. I'm gonna try to make the skin more blue by coloring in the warts with azure. I'm also gonna give those warty patches a dab of blue wash. And it's time to use some brown wash near the various straps and wraps, and also over the pauldron itself. Maybe if we dull down these clashing colors a bit, we can get them to play nicely. As another strategy to distract from the clashing colors, let's add some blood to the scene. This Fomoroid isn't carrying around a big axe or a sword, he's carrying around rocks. These are his favorite rocks for smashing. I'm also gonna add some chips and damage to the armor. I'm using yellow to highlight, and also add some scratches and distressed patches of paint. Then I came back in with black to deepen those gouges. This pauldron is starting to look pretty cool. I think this armor is almost working with the purple now. Close enough. This Fomoroid isn't supposed to be stylish. If someone gives him an orange shoulder pad, that's what he's gonna wear. That, a sweet eye patch, and some skulls. I'm ready to make bases for these lads now. My bases are the part of that small Chaos Army that I'm not quite happy with. I think they're close to something good though. I'm gonna try again and see if I can get them to a point where I'm willing to make 100 more for a full army. I'm using Milliput to make cobblestones. First, a layer of putty textured with rock. Then, a series of cuts to make a brick pattern. I like how durable these bases are when the Milliput hardens, and they have a nice weight to them. I also like that I can glue a magnet to the underside of the base for storage and transportation. It's a lot of work, but I do prefer this method over texture rollers or resin bases. The theme I want for this army is a marauding chaos force that has just broken through the walls and is running into a city. So these are bricks from the roads of a decently nice town, but they may be showing damage from the siege engines and magics that battered down the walls. I think I need a way to standardize the size of bricks between bases, but these are getting better. When the putty was cured, I primed the bases with light gray. For painting, I splotched on a few different shades of brown wash before giving them an all-over wash with black. I want to add a few more details, so I'm going to try to use texture paste and stones to make rubble. I wish I had some tiny bricks, but these pebbles do a decently good job. I also used a shield, a sword arm, and a sack as random bits. If I end up making a lot of these bases, I'll probably 3D print a variety of weapons and tools and other bits to mix into the rubble. Okay, let's add our boys to the bases and take a look. Hey, not bad. Once they were in context on their bases, I saw some details that I wanted to fix, and after another hour or so of improvements, I got to a place on both of these models that I'm really happy with. I decided to paint Bravely the Podcast and flick some blood at the Fomoroid. I think the effect is fun, and it makes sense with that bloody rock that he's carrying around. I'm timing this army project. I'm not rushing it, but I am timing it. I'm curious to know how long it really takes me to paint a Warhammer army outside of the context of a silly YouTube challenge. These two roids took me 22 hours to paint and base. 22 hours of happy hobby hibernation. Let's see how they look with the rest of the gang. Oh yeah, this is gonna be cool. These two are a great addition to the growing army. They add a ton of character to the scene, and a lot of options for making army lists. Now my force can be led by a Chaos Lord on Karkadrak, or an Ogroid Myrmidon, or both. I'm definitely gonna be painting some more standard troops and cavalry, but having a Fomoroid wandering around in the background and bashing things is delightful. And I was able to incorporate some yellow armor on both of those roids and kinda make it work. Nice. At this rate, the army project is gonna take a while, but that's alright. I'm loving how this is coming together. I'm having fun, and I've gotta be doing something with all this indoor time. This little scene makes me happy. Ordinarily, I have a really hard time committing to a paint scheme, but over the last year, I've had no second thoughts about this yellow. I'll probably play around with a few variants of the bases, but for the models themselves, I'm ready to dive on in and make some serious hobby progress this winter. Alright, I really do hope that you find ways to stay busy this winter. I believe that this is going to fly by, so let's try to make the most of it. And happy holidays! I'm wishing you all the best for a bright and healthy year. I'm gonna be right here though. I'm gonna be right here painting minis and making videos, so you'll be seeing me again soon. Thanks so much for watching and for keeping me company.